guys, welcome back to Auto Repair guys. In today's video guys, we'll show you how to remove or replace CV axle shaft on Ford Fiesta ST or MK7 guys, generation 2008-2017. We'll demonstrate how to remove or replace front left driver shaft, the CV axle, but it will be about the same procedure for the right side as well. We'll be taking the whole car apart, more than 200 videos, so if you need anything, subscribe, let us know guys, it takes quite a bit of time to make those videos, so we appreciate the support, so let's start on it now. So we'll be working on the front left side, and what we'll do, we'll actually install the tire chocks on the rear right. I usually do diagonal. Okay, and we'll jack the car up. You need to make sure that you get the lug bolts loose before you jack it up, but don't get them off, just break them loose. Always use a jack stand. Because if the jack fails, what happens? Just one little seal fails and everything will fall on you, so you definitely have to use a jack stand. Next, we're going to remove the lug nuts, 19mm socket there. And when we remove them, we're going to actually put the tire under the vehicle facing up so we can catch the wheel. So in case something happens, the jack fails, the jack stand fails as well, we're going to have an alternative to catch the car so it doesn't drop all the way down on us. So we'll need a 32mm socket, and if you don't have an impact, okay, we're using that little compressor here, works great with the impact, but you can use, you can have a person holding the brake inside really good, and you can use just a big ratchet to remove those breaker bar. Okay, so let's go ahead and remove the nut. Okay, perfect. Nut is out. You can see like that. Pretty simple. Pretty big locking nut as well. So next thing that we'll do, we'll need to remove the bolt that holds the control arm to the hub. So let me turn the light on. Okay, it's this bolt right there. On this side it's with 15mm nut, and on the other side it's a 13mm actually. We need to hold both of them. Okay, and just get it loose all the way. We're going to use a little impact here to save a little bit of time. Okay, perfect, and you can pull the bolt on the back side. Okay, let me show you what the bolt looks like now. Okay, this is the bolt and the nut. Okay, next with the pliant bar, we're going to bring the control arm down, okay, to pull it out of the bolt joint. Okay, just like that. It's very important not to pull too much this way, because otherwise you're going to pull the CV axle, okay, from the inner axle there, and it's a pain to put them together later. If you're replacing it, it's fine, but if you get a small rubber hammer, not to damage the thread, never use regular hammer, and you can just, okay, pull it like that towards the back. Okay, it's almost out, just a little bit more, it got stuck. So you can spray a little bit of penetrating oil right here. Okay, let's spray some in the splines, so that way it will lubricate better. Okay, and okay, we pull it out on this side. Okay, like that. Don't pull too much, not to damage your strut as well. Now we will need to use the bar, okay, the pry bar here that we have, to pull it out of the transmission side. You can use a big screwdriver too, so okay, let me just focus quick here what we're doing now. Okay, you can see right there. Okay, we need to okay, pull the axle out, and it has a spring there, so it's pretty stuck. Okay, screwdriver didn't do it for us, so we'll get a small pry bar. And if you have a lift to lift the car up, it's way easier. Okay, then what we are doing. Okay, ink got loose, and now we need to get a bucket. Your transmission fluid. Okay, because you leak some out. Later you need to refill it. Okay, and now we can go ahead actually and pull it out. Okay, it's still a little bit stuck, so okay, and we can go ahead and pull it out. You're going to leak some transmission fluid, you can see. So later you need to refuel your transmission. Okay, so we have the drive shaft out now. Okay, right here. So if you want to avoid that mess with the oil, guys, what you can do, okay, this is the drain plug. Okay, right there, that's drain plug. You can remove it. Later when you fill it up, okay, this is the fuel plug on the front side of the transmission. So that's where you're going to add your new fresh oil. Don't put the old one because you might have some dust in it from dripping on the suspension and stuff, and you don't want that dust and rocks to get in your transmission. Say bye bye to your tranny. So later when you get the new drive shaft, what you have to do, get it first on the transmission side, and you're going to push until it clicks all the way. The whole thing needs to be inside, and you can see this is the spring, okay, that holds it in place. So you have to make sure that you get it all the way in. Later you're going to install it, everything back together the same way with in reverse, or we took it apart. So that's pretty much it, guys. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe and see you next time.